Hello, I'm EnterElysium and welcome back to From the Depths, looking at the update for the advanced cannons. Now, since it's advanced cannons, advanced stuff. So we're talking about, like, advanced squared right now. This is going to be all the stuff that you need to make awesomer cannons or more niche cannons rather than just, you know, plain old bog standard cannon. So let's bring up the HUD. Boop. And firstly, we're going to talk about multiple barrels. So if I press Q on here, you'll notice that we've got a number of barrels. Doop, 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 doop. You can have six barrels. Of course, you can have two barrels. Which is maybe a little bit more realistic. But if we take it to six, you'll notice that the shell diameter is now 0.05. Because it divides the, effectively, the gauge of the shell by the number of barrels, and it does some maths, and it goes, okay, well, now your shells are going to be this large. So, if you notice, we're now re-racking all of our shells. There we go. You can see this one is loading up. And we don't need a two-long magazine anymore. We actually need just a one-long magazine. If you look at these shells, if we go over here, whoop, hello. Sorry about that. If we lower this to 0.05-ish. That'll do. You notice that we only need a one long. The shell length in on casing is 0.16. Expected muscle velocity. And you get all the stats. Let's also change the penetration depth use back to something more realistic. HE warhead body. And on the front, AP cap. Now, by the way, I've also confirmed that the changes to the base bleeder in the final release will be base bleeders are maybe not as good as gunpowder, but they don't increase cooldown, and they can maybe be loaded faster and stuff like that. Like, they don't increase cooldown was the main one, and there was something else about how they maybe don't need as long of barrels or something, and they've maybe more accuracy or something. Basically, they're not going to be as fast as gunpowder, but they're going to be better for your cannon doing other stuff. So, if we then make sure we're loading those. We're loaded? Okay. And then if we take control of the cannon. Now, the thing is, speed on that isn't that fast. If we check here, it'll say, oh, you should be firing once every 1.36. And then if you notice that the autoloader is, oh, come on, autoloader. Talk to me. There we go. Fine, don't tell me about yourself. Give me the autoloader. There we go, 0.75. The reason it's not doing that is because you don't have multiple autoloaders. We've only got one autoloader that's providing all these shells for all those barrels. What we'd have to do is add more autoloaders. So let's do that right now. Let's nuke. I probably want to keep the grit gauge increases. Okay, let's go back like this. And let's just get rid of everything over here. That. So we've got six barrels, okay? So what we'll need is basically six autoloaders. So I would want advanced custom cannon. Autoloader. I would like six long autoloader. Can you add an autoloader like that, I wonder? Yes, you can. Okay, in which case I don't need any of this. We can go, maybe do. Autoloader. 1, 2, 3. And if we go out the other side. We need to go one more over. Because we need to be able to get the clips in. 1, 2, 3. Okay. So here we've got six autoloaders. If we then give them clips. I would like a one clip. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now, problem is, we're not going to be able to load from multiple different directions. Because we can't load from the front or the back. For this one we can only load from the back as well. So this is maybe not optimal. But it'll give you an idea. So if we go and get an input. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And apparently I've got... Aha, you hiding there. Go away. There should be now six taken. Yes, 6 of 6. Where are the shells? There is somewhere. Oh, there we go. They're filling in evenly. Huzzah! Now, it's feeling quite silly because we've only got one loader input each. We could add more clips. Another clip here, another clip here, another clip here. And we'll do that in a second because currently it's just one times faster. So what we'll see is every 1.36 seconds, I believe it was, 1.36 seconds, we'll be firing six shells. So... and notice, look, six shells all at once. So but what we're doing right now is we're firing basically, I don't want to be in build mode, a load at once. Now, of course, you can change this if you want to go up here. You can be like, I want to set the fire delay. Roughly, it's firing once every 3.6 seconds. So let's just check that. There we go. So if we were to say, set this to 1.4, we should get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, small gap, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And there we go. Now, of course, we can increase the load time. Let's go back to not controlling it. So if we were to do this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, there we go. And on the side now, of course, I can't actually do ones here because I can't then connect them to anywhere. I actually made a massive mistake here. I don't have anywhere to connect these two because if I did that and then I did this, where am I going to put the inputs? I'm going to have to delete the two in the middle. So one, two, three. Mm-hmm. And if we put down a mirror line, there we go. Can do this a lot quicker. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two. Now, this is only increasing by 0.7, and this is increasing by, hey, it should be 0.7. It should be faster than that. We need more outputs. So let's go make some more outputs. Oop, I need to be on the base. Do, 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 do. One, two, three, four. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one. One. There we go. Fill. Go back to the turret, and I should be able to set all of these new ones up. There we go. And the shell is now firing 0.7 times faster. If it would actually fill all the clips. There we go, 0.57. Because it's got three clips. Once it gets onto the fourth clip, we'll see it even faster. Come on. There we go, 0.5. So with four clips, you can get down to 0.5 times faster. So basically twice as fast for firing. Now, of course, the problem is this middle one will not be quite as fast. So we will see some weirdness in how it fires, but we should see an appreciable increase in the firing time. So I'm going to just reduce this to 0.05. So it should still stutter, but we should be able to see how fast and much it can fire. Okay, you fully loaded? You look fully loaded. See, there we go. We've got a massively fast firing, rapid fire, six barrel gun, which does a bit weird bit of stuttering because A, I've set it up to fire six, small gap, fire six, small gap. And also because two of the barrels are getting fed by slower loading autoloaders. However, that should be pretty cool. And in fact, it should work. So let's spawn something in for it to work against. Now, remember, if these get hit, these will explode. Because they have HE shells in them, and they act like they have HE shells in them. If you hit this, they will explode. So remember to armor your clips, people. Let's spawn in an Atlas, because that seems to be a pretty easy target. It's made of wood. It doesn't have much in the way of firepower, so it won't kill us, and we can try against it. Ooh, it looks like I might have the range. There we go. We're hitting it. Remember, these are very small gauge shells. They're only 6 centimeters. There we go, we're getting some consistent firepower downrange now. Now, the damage it's doing isn't much. You can see there's very little of the hull's properly ripped away, but there are sections. You can see along the front here, sections of the hull being ripped. However, against flyers, probably not a bad plan. Now here you can see a small problem with the current advanced cannons in that the bullets do bounce quite a lot from water. So you will see bullets that landing short just bouncing over, etc. You'll see that it tends to aim a little bit too far over. But in all, this is a pretty cool cannon. At least I say so. Right, let's delete the enemy. I would like to destroy you. Bam. Right. So let's talk about... Ooh, what do I want to talk about next? Railguns or frag? Railguns, why not? Okay. So let us grab this. Now, we know that the shell length is currently only a 1 meter shell rack. So if we want to create something that flies incredibly fast and... did like load of damage, we could go for something that has all parts gunpowder, and then a sabo head. So we should get a muzzle velocity of over 800 meters per second. Now, how far can we make this without going into a 2 meter shell rack? Longer. Now, we'll have a slower reload time. 1 meter. 2 meters. Go away, stupid menu. 2 meters. 2 meters. Oh, 1 minute, it just changed. Okay, so I want you to be gunpowder. I want you to be a saber warhead. We're getting expected muscle velocity of basically 1.9 kilometers per second. Kinetic damage of 737, pierce of 60. Okay. Now, we need to empty the current shells in there. So, an easy way of being able to do that is if I go number of barrels and change it, it'll change the gauge. So, it empties all the barrels, and then it'll start loading again. And there you go. You notice that these extra long, mostly gunpowder shells have been created. Now, because we've done that, the shells are a lot bigger. The length is much, much larger. So if we go and have a look, you'll see that we have a firing time, expected reload from clips of 2.36, which we're, you know, reducing roughly to half, but we are still getting a very, very slow reload time. So if we fire... Now, we could add more autoloaders. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to increase this to about 0.2. Yeah, there we go. That's not bad. Still reloading ammo up here. Okay, I don't want to control the turret. And now I want to put on a railgun part. Now, the reason I did that is because railguns, really the best thing about them is the speed. Now, you can use them for anything. You can use them to, you know, lob mortars or something if you wanted. But really the best thing about a railgun is if you want to go for crazy speed. So, we've got crazy fast ammo. We'll make it faster. So, let's just check the current velocity. Ah, we've got a small bug. Bug current exists where you can't follow the ammo sometimes if you do some weird things with the turret and you change things and you come back and suddenly you can't. It's something to do with the number of barrels. I don't know what, but you suddenly can't follow the projectile. So we're just going to have to take the word for this, that the muzzle velocity is 1.9. Now, this is based on the fact if we have 15 barrels. We don't have 15 barrels, so let's put 15 barrels down and we should get a 1.9 kilometer per second. So, boop. That's not the right one. Boop. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Let's go for 15. And we should get a very rapid firing. The cooldown is 0.11 seconds, which is fine. And that's, you know, the limiting factor is really how fast we can get ammo in the gun currently. And then we want to put on railgun systems. So, railguns. I need to move this. Move you to here. Now, I didn't put back and front loaders on these clips just because the clips should have enough ammo for quite a while in there. When they don't, meh. But whatever. For now, we're going to talk about railguns. So I'm going to put a mirror line down the center. And I'm going to grab a railgun magnet fixture attachment. This goes next to the firing piece. The firing piece is here. There we go. Now, this is what you're going to put the rails on. So next to the firing piece, you can put them above or below. We could put one above as well. You can put one below, but we're kind of actually using below. I wonder if we can place one there. I can. Ooh, nice. Okay, so we have our railgun magnet fixture. We now need to attach railgun barrel magnet. So if we place these like so. And like so. Ooh, I can't put it here because of the mantle we're using. Okay. So let's put a different mantle on. Mantle, 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 mantle. There we go. Now you only need to use like however many rails you want. We're using the maximum amount, which is 4. Now, these take charge from batteries. Batteries, if we go find them in the advanced cannon block. Here. Batteries get charged up by railgun charger. Railgun chargers get their charge from an engine. Yes, I know. It's a very long and complicated system. Which is why this is the advanced video. If we go get engine. Engine block. I'm going to use a prefab engine for now. New object. Prefab. Max engine. Yes, this is a crazy engine. Let's go back and grab resources. Fuel storage tank. Power output is nearly 100,000. Fuel processor. There we go. Now, it's not taking any energy at the moment, so that's why it's silent. But as soon as we add batteries on, we should be good. So let's go get advanced cannon. Battery. Edit the cannon. And put battery here. Now, the way batteries work is you want to have 4 sides to attach charges on. So if we go out here. If we were to go out here. Here. And here. We can then add charges. So we grab charges. And you want as many charges as possible. So if we go down. Have I got them? No, I don't have the mirror line. Let's put a mirror line in, because these are mirrored. You see that this railgun charge and the railgun's starting to spin. Now, these will charge faster with more charges. Currently, the battery isn't full. It's still getting up speed, still getting up speed, still getting up speed. Let's see how long it will take to get up speed. We've already added 330 meters per second. 350 meters per second. But it's taking a long time because of the charges. So we should add more charges because no one wants to be waiting forever for their railgun to charge. Put more charges here. And there we go. We've got 500 meters per second boost. Railgun usage next shot. It's going to use 9,000 of our 18,000 charge next shot. And this is the reason you don't have rapid fire railguns. completely honest, this is the reason you have rapid-fire railguns. Because by using our rails, we're taking a lot of charge from our capacitors, and they will not be able to charge fast enough. Demonstration. You didn't even see the projectile, it's so fast. And look at that. We're now charging up again. We've completely, like, lost all the charge. And it's still charging, it's still charging, it's still charging. You notice we've got basically four capacitors for every battery. Most of them. And we are still charging, and we finally hit peak charge. Now, of course, we could have it firing in a burst, and all of the first ones get the extra burst of speed. But that would require even more batteries. Currently, no, we're not giving a very much an appreciable boost. So, what are we going to do? Well, ideally, we'd change it down to one barrel. For this purposes, you already know railguns have a problem with fast firing. But that's fine. They're not designed to be super fast firing. Ideally, what you want for a railgun is basically a large artillery piece that goes BAM! BAM! Not da-da-da-da-da-da-da. It just doesn't work like that. But I will show you what this does now. Maybe we should add a few more batteries before we do that, just because I'd like to get, you know, a few shots out. If we do that, that should give room for capacitors. There we go. Capacitors here, capacitors down the front. And I think we are ready to test fire this puppy. Ah! There we go. And I'll add the ones on the end. I'll add end caps. But you now notice it says the speed increase is 777, and it'll still use half the charge. Because currently that's the way that rails are set up. It's very unintuitive. This may change, but rails currently take a percentage of the stored charge. If you have four rails, spending the entire barrel, whatever, we manage to get up to 50% of the charge. If I needed one rail, it would be a lot less. But that's how it currently works. It may change in future. I would love it to change. It's very unintuitive. But that's how it currently works. So if I back out here, I can't follow the shell, which is annoying! God damn it. Okay, let's spawn in an enemy. And I will control the cannon so that I can finally get a view. And okay, cannon, have your fun. Notice just parts just disappeared. Now, any shots from now on aren't really railgun accelerated. They're railgun accelerated by the speed at which it can charge it between shots, but that's going to be maybe 30 meters per second or something. It's not going to be very much. But any shots hitting it right now are just doing so much damage. They're probably not going straight through, but they're probably going through several blocks. Now, the collateral damage it's doing isn't crazy. Any ship that's made of metal would not take as much damage, and it probably could repair faster than this cannon could do damage to it. However, this is still pretty hilarious to watch. Oh, diddums. Question is, can it eat through to the ammo hole? You can see it start chipping away. Come on, chip away faster. Do it, I believe in you. You can't even see the shells, it's just going so fast. Very occasionally you see a line of blue, but other than that, you just see bits disappearing. Because it is firing them at, you know, 2 kilometers per second. which especially from the depths where most shells travel at about 300 meters per second is. There we go, there's the ammo store, and two damaged. Pretty fast. And of course, because they're going faster, they have a flatter trajectory. You don't have to leave the target so much. Pretty useful. And boom. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of the railgun part. We don't need that for the rest of today's demonstration. If you would kindly stop being a railgun, that would be grand. I think I just took away the ammo box. Yes, I did. Why have you not fallen off yet? Aha, I see. There we go. And I need to destroy the rails. Do 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 do. This rail is destroyed, it's just not appeared to be destroyed. Okay, and I need an ammo box again. Ammo box, ammo box, ammo box, ammo box, ammo box, ammo box. Ammo router, there we go. Right, so let's demonstrate flak, which is going to be shells that explode via either a timer or an altitude. So either of those works fine. We might demonstrate a probably altitude fused shell. So if we grab a AA mantlet, since we're going to be working in sort of an AA role right now. Probably don't need quite so long a barrel. There we go. And we will need, this is very important, a laser targeter. Allows automatic setting of timer and altitude fuse parameters, particularly useful when used with an AI. Bam! This is going to be important. So let's also change the number of barrels down to, say, 2. And we can see that the shell diameter is 0.089. So we will want to get this down to 0.089. Shell rack length needed 2. I don't want that. I would like it to be 1, so it can fit inside the currently existing shell cases. Magazines, clips. 2. 1, there we go. Okay, so we've got our wish. So I would like a lot of gunpowder, that's fine. I would then like a frag warhead body. Okay, I want loads of those. I also want a altitude fuse. Frag warhead body, frag warhead body, frag warhead body, and a nose. I would like a This is a hard choice, because I'm not going to be hitting the target. I'm going to explode before I hit them. So I want something that flies fast. Speed modifier. Slow. Speed modifier. Fast. But it reduces explosive damage by 25%. I have frags, not explosive. High velocity AP for thin to medium armors, although a composite head would work quite nicely as well. Yeah, we'll add a composite head then. So we've got an arm pierce, it doesn't really matter. Expected recoil force, blah, 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 kinetic damage. We need 7 barrels for our propellant burn, preferably 8. Muzzle velocity a little bit on the slow side, but that's acceptable. Fragments, 30. Okay, so let's set the fragments to a cone angle of 180, which means they explode all around. Bear in mind that the fragments will still have the velocity of the projectile, which means that they will explode still moving at 267.9 meters per second. So let's go over here. Have I lost the connection? Do I need to reconnect all of these guys? Yeah. All the ones over here don't seem to be connected. Ah, because I had the mirror line on when I did the ammo routers. There we go. Now, let us try and find out what the firing speed of this is going to be. Remember, it's only got two barrels. 3.72. But we are feeding it with a load of ammo routers. Let's just wait for the ammo routers to fill up. But what should happen is this should fire. Let's check the cooldown. Okay. What's the cooldown? I don't want the turret to turn. Come back. Thank you. Half a second. So maybe we could do with improving the cooldown. So let's go. Let's grab barrel. And muzzle brake. No. Bore evacuator. Yes. And we also need a longer barrel anyway. So let's just make that two bigger. And then put a muzzle brake on the end. Which will... Sorry, a bore evacuator. Which will do cooldown modifier. Will go down by 10%. Let's also get the left, right... And cooldowns. There we go. And we should be able to... Cooldown is now down to half a second. For each barrel. Now, that's important. If you've got a barrel that was, like, really overheating, you could have multiple barrels. And the cooldown is for each barrel, so you can fire multiple shells. That's another great thing about multiple barrels. Now... I'm going to mention it. I'm not going to use it here. There is an overclock. Overclocking means allows firing before the cooldown period is finished. Firing before properly cooled down gives an accuracy decrease and a recoil increase. So we could overclock. Like, yeah, sure. Fire a second before you're overheat, before you're, you know, sorted. Oh, God, I've just changed the ammo again. Fire 4 seconds before you're, you know, ready to fire again. This allows you to fire something incredibly fast that would be hot. As it is, I don't think we have much of an issue, but I will just set the overclock to max just to see if it'll change anything. And we still need to get more ammo, which is the problem with having only one ammo route on each clip. Now, bear in mind, the ammo routes don't really work for the clip. They work for the entire loader. So we've got... Hey! You've lost your ammo loaders. That's not on. There we go. I'm going to speed this up a little bit by putting on additional ammo loaders, which I think should work. There we go. A little bit. So notice how that one clip's been filled before the other two clips are filled. That is because these aren't really working on the clips, they're working on the ammo loader. But they are attached to the clip. So they're filling up one, then they're filling the next one, and then they're going to fill this one. So any second now, we should see more ammo coming to this clip. Come on. Show me the ammo. Show me the ammo. Don't make me a liar. Don't make me a liar. There we go. You can see we've got some shells now. And so if we were to take control of the gun. I think we are actually in the overclock period. We're firing very fast. Way faster than that cooldown. So I think we are in the overclock period. Now I will just change the fire delay so it fires a little bit slower. So it should now fire. Five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now, can you guess why there's basically six gap, six gap? You guessed it. It's because we have six autoloaders. So each autoloader is going, oh, you're out of ammo. Here's a shell. Bam, 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 bam. Oh, you're out of ammo. Here's a shell. Bam, bam, bam. But because each autoloader does it separately, we're getting effectively... six times the ammo. Now, of course, it's, you know, three per muzzle. But it's because each ammo loader goes, you're out of ammo, passes it a shell, it fires off the shells, then it requests them. So it's firing, it's providing six shells every... 3.72. Admittedly, mostly half because the ammo loaders provide them faster. So it's providing, you know, 6 shells much faster than that, to 2 barrels. So what we should see is this firing pretty fast, which we are, which is nice. Now, here's the fun part. Oh, I'll just take the camera up. Laser targeter. So, safety distance, won't explode before this. Offset altitude, offset time. I want you to explode, say, 16 meters in front of your target. And that means in front of your target altitude. So if against a flat target that's dead ahead, it'll just explode out of the barrel, because that is our target altitude. Against a target above us, it would explode literally 15 meters below. So, let's try this puppy out. Got no idea if this is going to work. Hopefully it will. And we notice it says current fuse time is 5.3 seconds. Because it's at a low altitude, it's exploding immediately. It would need to be at a higher altitude. So ta-da, we found a problem. Because it's not at a high altitude, we're exploding instantly, the shell goes out. Because the shell checks, okay, what's the enemy altitude? The enemy altitude, say, is 50. What altitude are we? 40. Okay, when are we meant to explode? 60 meters before 50. Okay, explode immediately. If we were using a time fuse, that wouldn't be a problem. So if we were to use, say, something faster as a target, so let's go get a plane, Drake Light. Now, will it still explode immediately we leave the barrel? Like, no, it's high enough. No, it's not high enough. It's exploding immediately. Come on, get higher. I know you can. You're a plane. Now, because it's far away, it will hit the altitude quite far in front. Seriously, is this the highest you can go? I am disappointed. I'll start passing time fuses if you like this. Okay, I'm going to take control of the gun so that we can just prevent that temporarily. And I'm going to grab this and I'm going to say, you know what? Screw it. Just explode like 4 meters in front, right? Well, altitude. And there we go. See, they're getting to the required altitude right next to it. And we're getting flak everywhere. Notice how they're exploding. Doing damage. It's probably a little bit close now. Now, you'd get the same thing with a time shell, except the time shell worked better at long range. Oh, hello. Are you shooting your own engine? You are. And there you go, you shot your own ammo barrels. I think you need a little bit of work, mate. Oh, hello. Nice, nice kill. Now, bear in mind that this laser targeter needs to be directly attached to the firing piece. You have no other choice. It has to be directly attached to the firing piece. So just bear that in mind. Unlike the normal, target predictor. So, multiple barrels. Overheating, overclocking. Railguns. Flak. And the advanced targeting firing thingy. I think we've covered pretty much everything. I'm looking around here. I can't really see more that we want to really expand upon. We could, you know, talk about different shells and use the different shells more than just, say, the Sabo or the AP Cat, which we've done. But to be honest, I think they're, you know, we've explained what they do. I don't think we need to really try them out. I mean, that'd be literally trying every single shell would take quite a while. I think that that covers pretty much everything there is in the advanced canon update. I don't think I have missed anything. Now, of course, at some point, I'll probably have to do a tutorial rather than just a little three-form poke at it. But I cannot wait to start using these in my series. It's going to be so fun. Hopefully you've enjoyed this. If you have, remember to like and not subscribe. Please consider subscribing. Oh, it's so awesome. I'm EnterElysium. And stay shiny.
Hype.